Hello, my name is John Thornton, and you're about to watch a film I made of a conversation I had with my very, very good friend, the artist John Whitney. As we talk, you'll get to see some of John's amazingly beautiful paintings. But I do have one little warning. John, unfortunately, is bald. And of course, there's nothing wrong with being bald. But his head is so shiny that at times light can bounce off it and potentially injure your eye. So I recommend when John's on camera, you might want to wear some sunglasses. With that one little warning in mind, enjoy Conversations with John Whitney. We're lifelong best friends, and we have a lot of things in common, but there are some differences. When did you start losing your hair, John?
It was just tragic. Probably in my early 30s, my hairline started to recede. It was just tragic.
It is sad.
My wife almost left me. It was just terrible.
Well, you know, it's not easy being this good looking. The chicks are, you know, oh, shoot. I think one spots me from across the way. Busy. We'll come back later. Anyway, John is a heck of an interesting guy. And what we're going to do now is just go through a few little stories from his past just to, that I revere. When John was in the second grade, he was living in North Philadelphia with his mother. The two of them were alone and they were in a state of poverty. And he turned on the TV set and a large rat walked by John as he was watching Mickey Mouse or whatever it was. And I was horrified and I said, well, what did your mother say? And John replied, I never told my mother. I didn't want her to be worried. Is it true or false?
Well, that's true, but in the state of poverty, my mother actually did work. She was a single working mother, which is a really tough thing to do. So I didn't want to put any more burdens on her than she already had. But my mother was really tough. She was, you know, she raised me, you know, worked her whole life. Tough, a real tough woman.
John is the true stoic friend that I've had. Okay, next story. We move the time clock forward. We're in Vietnam. Well, I'm not. I have a student deferment. But John is in Vietnam. And one of his friends drunkenly staggers into town, gets even more drunk, and then in the middle of the night is staggering back to the base. And what happens to him?
Actually, nothing. But the interesting thing about the story is he walked past some armed VC. He went in to visit some prostitutes, so. And the VC would tax the prostitutes. So for some reason, they didn't bother him. They just let him go by.
Because he was a cash cow for them.
Yeah, I imagine. That's speculation, but I would think so. And also, I want to just, the Vietnam thing, I was in maintenance, so I wasn't in combat at all. I mean,
you got mortared.
Well, a few times it would, but they never came too close. Really, just once they came kind of close. But other than that, you know, it was really safe. It was probably safer to be in Philadelphia.
I admire John so much that I am going to do, out of solidarity, I'm going to just literally pull my hair out so that I can know the horrors of what he's lived like. All right, girls.
Okay, this is.
Oh, ow, that hurts.
John and I used to always joke around about is who was balder. And I hate to admit this, but John actually has more hair than I do.
Well, except neither of us are all that good. Okay, thank
well,
you.
Well, actually,
John.
I do have a little more hair. I actually shaved it off, so. It will grow back, but I hate to admit it, but John does have more hair than I have.